Internal Affairs Minister Kahinda Otafire was appearing before the Parliamentary Committee on Physical Infrastructure yesterday when he made the controversial statements.
I don't want to pretend that I know much about this project. The first time I got to know about this project, other than from the press, was when Mr. Wavamuno wrote to me complaining.
The Parliamentary Committee on Physical Infrastructure is considering a petition by the Kampala City Traders Association challenging the digital number plates to be rolled out by the government. Otafire informed MPs that he wrote to President Museveni warning him against contracting a Russian company to manage the digital number plates after realizing that it was going to shut down a local manufacturer.
I intimated to him that it would be a bit sensitive for us to shut down a local manufacturer in favor of importation of number plates when we can do it here, or if there are any difficulties, we could see how to overcome them. I've never received a reply. I doubt whether the president ever saw that communication.
Otafire added that the police team which went to Russia to carry out due diligence against MS Joint Stock Company Global Security that is implementing the project discovered that there was no evidence of the company executing a project of such nature anywhere in the world.
When they inquired about where the number plates were being done, were being manufactured, they wanted to visit the factory. That they were told the factory was in Poland. And as far as I'm concerned, Poland is technically at war with Russia.
Responding to Otafire's utterances today, Security Minister Jim Muhwezi wondered how his fellow minister, who is a member of cabinet, could distance himself from a project that was discussed at the highest level of government of which he is a member.
Cabinet decided which part of government should handle. Much as it does not matter which ministry is handling. But in this case, it is being handled by the Minister of Security and the Minister of Works and Transport. Although there are others who are involved, like Attorney General, Chambers, like Police, which is Internal Affairs, and others like Nita Yu.
Muhwezi called Otafire a liar for claiming he knows nothing about the project. He said Otafire should be ashamed of himself.
The police is part of the project management team. So what he was saying was a lie. So that's why I don't know whether I should say so. Because he was lying. Because he said he doesn't know about the project. And that be true? When he was in the cabinet, Even last Monday, we talked about it in cabinet when he was there. So shame on him.
Muhwezi maintained that the government's position is that the project will continue as planned and will start in November.
The position of government is that the project is going on, and we expect it to be implemented and to provide the benefits of it, which is to curb insecurity, among others.
On complaints about the price of the digital number plates, Muhwezi clarified that all vehicles will pay 150,000 shillings and not 700,000 shillings, and that motorcycles will pay 50,000 shillings and not 150,000 shillings unless they are not registered means of transport. Muhwezi emphasized that Otafire was not speaking for the government but for himself.
Government is speaking with one voice because the Ministry of Works and Transport and the Ministry for Security, which are the designated government ministries, are speaking with one voice. So the other voice coming from the Honorable Minister of Internal Affairs does not speak for this project. He's speaking for himself and his interests.
He promised that Ugandans would soon be sensitized on the project. Report by Charles Etukuri for the news.